by the way you talk, by the way you live your life. Because today, the gospel is not just preaching. To be an agent of the gospel is not just to preach. We are many preachers. Excellent, perfect homilies, preachers. But the world is looking for those who will live out the gospel, who will preach by their life. And that is why this message is for you and I. That just like Philip brought joy to this Samaritan town, you and I, we are called to bring joy to everyone we meet. There at your office, where you sit, God has given you that office. You occupy it. You go every morning to sit there. There you preach the gospel. You give joy to people. If you fail to give joy to people from that your office, you have failed to proclaim the word of God. Today, as I say, we have many Christians. Those who can preach, those who can pray, those who can even speak in tongues, and even speak in noise. But does it end here? Where are those people that occupy positions? Where are those people that we look at young graduates and ask them to bring 500,000 naira or 1 million naira so that they will give them job? Where are they? Are they not Christians? Some of them are Christians. Some of them are Muslims. All of them believe in God. But the position God has given to you, you turn that position to sorrow. Because you are talking of joy and sorrow. The position God has given to you, the life God has given to you, the opportunity God has given to you, you turn it to sorrow. It is a condemnable atrocity that cries to heaven, and it's happening in Nigeria, and even becoming a culture and a tradition, that people ask people to bring money to give them appointments, job opportunities. 500,000 naira, 1 million naira in Nigeria. That graduate you are asking to bring money. Where do you expect the person to get the money? Atrocity in Nigeria. When shall we repent in this country?